How do you explain? How do you describe a love that goes from east to west and runs as deep as it is wide? You know all our hopes, Lord, you know all our fears. Words could not express the love we feel, but we long for you to hear. So listen to our hearts, hear our spirits sing a song of praise that flows from those you have redeemed. Words we know to tell you what an awesome God you are. But when words are not enough to tell you of our love, just listen to our hearts. If words could fall like rain from these lips of mine, if I had a thousand years, I would still run out of time. So if you listen to my heart, every beat will say, thank you for the life, thank you for the truth, thank you for the way. Listen to our hearts,
oh, please listen,
hear our spirits sing,
and hear us sing,
a song of praise that flows,
a song of praise,
from those you have redeemed,
those you have redeemed,
and we will use the words we know to tell you what an awesome God. But when words are not enough to tell you of our love, just listen to our hearts. Listen to my heart, every beat will say, thank you for the light, thank you for the truth, thank you for the way. And listen to our heart,
please listen,
hear our spirits sing. A song of praise that flows,
a song that flows
from those you have redeemed,
you have redeemed.
And we will use the words we know to tell you what an awesome God you are. But when words are not enough to tell you of our love, just listen to our heart. Words are not enough to tell you of our love. Just listen to our hearts. Listen to our hearts.
Oh Lord, please listen.
Listen to.
Good morning, friends. Good to meet with you again this morning. Seems that as if this last week has been quite topsy-turvy for us, with regulations changing, but also with crisis within our community. And so I welcome you. I welcome you warmly. But already I'm welcoming you with a pastoral heart. And we're going to use this service as a time of caring for one another, pastorally reaching out to each other and asking the Lord to guide us and to be with us. So welcome to you. Last Saturday, we had our synod here in the foyer of our church. And that's not the whole synod that met here. Just our Garden Route circuit met with me in the foyer. And the others from our synod had a virtual meeting with me. So those from the R and Colesberg, or Graaf Reinet, Mossel Bay, George, even in the central region, central Karoo regions too, all met with me and with our bishop and the other leaders of our circuit and our synod last Saturday. So thank you for your prayers. It was a difficult one in terms of technology, but a synod that worked nevertheless. Please make sure you keep up to date with the information from our church. So refer to the bulletin, please. It's on our website. And don't forget, that is www.plettmethodist.co.za. And information from past services, prayer lists, as I said, the bulletin, and lots of other infos on the website. So please visit it regularly to keep up to date with what's going on in the life of our church. At the outset, I said this is a pastoral service. So I really would like to ask you in your prayers to embrace the families of our church. And I'm not going to mention names of people on our social media platform like this, but just to say there are families in our church and individuals who need your prayers. So please remember them at this time. Hold them close to the Father's heart. And so today we're going to have a service of prayer and a service for healing. And so words will appear on your screen. And I invite you to participate by saying them out loud with me or with the narrator. Or if you'd prefer, simply remain silent and read them to yourself. Readings, hymns, songs, I will not introduce them separately today, but simply allow the service to flow from one section into the other in a very prayerful, quiet, meditative way. And our readings, our prayers, our songs will lead us to the Lord's table. And so I invite you to share communion with me this morning as well. And as we gather around the Lord's table, so we remember it's at his table, we really experience not only the message of healing and hope, but we understand Jesus come for us, Jesus born into this world to live amongst us. Jesus with us in every way. Now, our opening hymn will be one that we normally use at Christmas time. And obviously it has Christmas themes in it, but it picks up on this idea that I've just shared of Jesus born to be with us. Jesus with us in our current time. And so it will remind us that we worship God in and through the gift of who Jesus is, born to move amongst us, born to show us the love of God at work, born to bring love and peace and healing to all people. And then our prayer service is an adaptation from the Reverend John van der Laar's Communion for Liturgy for Healing. So John, thank you. And so we begin now with our invitation. This is a time of healing. This is a time of comfort. This is a time to receive the gift of new hope. This is the time to strengthen our faith. This is a time the God who made the universe waits to embrace us. This is a time we come to feel God's healing touch again. With all that we are, parts that are whole and parts that are broken, parts that are well and parts that are sick, parts that are joyful and parts that are in pain. With all that we are, we come to worship you, O God. For you are gracious, merciful, and kind, and we long to find our rest in you.
Come, thou long expected. God of mercy and compassion, we acknowledge that we are not all that we would like to be. We carry wounds and regrets, some of which are of our own design, and some of which we have received from others. We acknowledge our failings, our bitterness, and our hatreds, and ask you to heal us of all our sin. Forgive us, O God, in all our weakness. Strengthen us, O God. From all our diseases, heal us, O God. Amen.
We believe in God, the Creator of all that we see and all that we do not see. We believe in Jesus Christ, God become flesh, in death the forgiver of sinners, in rising the healer of the broken. We believe in the Holy Spirit, God within us, comforter, guide, and friend.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not, thy compassions, they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see.
Prove
Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father.
Heavenly Father, fill our prayers with power and our hearts with faith. We pray for healing, for comfort, for wisdom, for courage, and for strength during this time of pandemic. Father, be with us in the isolation of our homes and the lonely desperation within our communities. In your compassion, hold the sick close to your heart. Surround the healthcare workers, doctors, and nurses with your presence, and give them courage in these times of darkness and difficulty. Father, give unflagging endurance and tenacity to all those working tirelessly to get food, shelter, and essential supplies to the poor and the homeless. Father, be with the families shattered by grief and with all who struggle with the heartbreaking pain of loss. In your mercy, heal us, O God. We pray for healing from hatred, healing from racism, and healing from brutality and violence, especially for healing from the attacks on our women and our children. We pray for healing from these and all the plagues of destruction and division in our nation. In your mercy, heal us, O God.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Sing with me, "And Can It Be?"
And can it be that I
Oh,
Jesus came to seek the lost, to heal the sick, to free the captive, and restore the broken. We give thanks for his love that never ends. As part of his work of healing, Jesus left us the sacrament to remind us of his love, to invite us into his grace, and to extend to us new hope and new life. So we remember at his last meal with his friends before he died, Jesus took bread, blessed it, and broke it, and then shared it, saying, "This is my body broken. Eat it and remember me." After they had eaten, he took wine, blessed it, and shared it, saying, "This is my blood shed. Drink it and remember me." And so we eat and drink with grateful hearts, and we remember the sacrifice of Jesus, which makes us whole. Amen. So we take and eat the body of Christ given for us. We are truly thankful, and we celebrate for new life received. Amen. We take and we drink and we remember that Jesus loves us, that he died for us, his blood was shed to wash away our sins. We say, "Thank you, Father." Amen. Friends, to bring our worship to a close, we're going to sing a great, great hymn of thanksgiving and celebration. "Praise my soul, the King of heaven, to his feet thy tribute bring." And perhaps if you're sitting down at home, you'd like to stand for this, and you'd like to gather all your energy, focus your spirit in your lungs, and sing it out, because it is a hymn to lead us as people of hope and people who have been healed into the week that lies ahead. And we remember our country. We remember all those who need our love and our prayers and healing at this time. "Praise my soul, the King of heaven." I'm sure heaven enjoyed that. I believe the angels celebrated with us as we sang the song. So let's say our closing benediction prayer now. Touched by your grace, we take your grace to the world. Healed by your love, we take your love to the world. Renewed by your Spirit, we go in the Spirit's power to be agents of your healing. Amen. Have a great week. Have a blessed week. May it be one of peace and healing. In Jesus' name.